The Jon Pertwee Book of Monsters. John, why do we all love creepy crawlies and monsters?
Oh, it's fantasy, isn't it? It's what the Jews, what the children said. They revel in it, all the blood and the guts and the gore.
They are bloodthirsty lot,
of course
they
are. Yes, yeah. They love it. I mean, all children used to watch monsters. Then they watched Doctor Who. They used to hide under the table or behind a chair. But you try to put them outside the door, they'd object very strongly.
We just love being frightened, don't we? And we carry this on into adulthood, I suppose.
Of course, yes.
Your book, Collection of Monsters, have you a favourite in this one?
Yes, I think there's the Somala plant by George Evans. I like that best because that's a plant that really exists, a plant that eats flies. I was walking through a field in Martinique once after having rather a lot of rum, and a plant actually sat up and grabbed a friend of mine by the ankle. And he really did. As he walked by, I went and grabbed him by the ankle.
Really?
And I thought that was very alarming. I said that's a good basis of the story of a plant that eats flies and then eventually goes for human beings. It gets bigger and bigger and bigger.
Yes. Well, of course, you were involved with the odd nasty and horror yourself, were you not, in your persona as Doctor Who? I've often wondered when you're making those things. I mean, television studios are so false in a sense, but were you ever frightened yourself by anything that happened to you in making that series?
No, not really. It's very hard to be frightened by cardboard and tin and with a chap inside it that you just had lunch with. but there was one great occasion when I was in some China clay pits down in Reigate or somewhere, and there was an actor who was dressed in a draconian skin, which is a marvellous makeup, using the half mask. When we got on this half mask, we used the human face and the eyes, but the rest is mask. And he was talking about, he was a great authority on the stars and outer space. And he was talking for about 3/4 of an hour about his knowledge of this. And I suddenly caught myself out that I really believed him. I suddenly came to and realized with tremendous shock that for half an hour I'd been transported into space. And I felt this is what it was really like.
Yes.
I believed this man. Yes, yes. That was alarming. Yes.
Well, I'm afraid we're not going to frighten you tonight because we have something of a surprise for you. And we thought you were going to fall off the back of your chair and all that. We've actually got a Dalek, is it? You said the chap you just sort of had lunch with.
Oh, there he is. It's Fred, yes.
Greetings to the human noise, Doctor.
That is...
Jon Pertwee.
That is the voice of John Scott Martin. I'd recognize it anywhere. Am I right?
But that's Dalek. Jon Pertwee, as usual, is right.
We weren't exactly alarmed. Thank you very much indeed, John. You weren't exactly frightened. You see, I've always found those terrifying. Absolutely. Can you pop out of the top? Is that possible for you to do? Or are you locked in there, Mr. Dalek?
Can we get you out, John?
Would it be allowed?
Yes.
It would be allowed. We'd love to just see you.
Shall I take the top off?
Yes.
Right. Do. Release him. Is it the old... Oops.
No, it's the new... The top is loose. Mind
your head. Right, there you are.
Ta-da! Well, he's not frightening once you see him. Thank you very much indeed.
Originally, they were very frightening because what was inside them was a gigantic great jelly with an eyeball in the middle of
that
it.
That was extremely frightening.